Welcome back to Squawk on the Street. Rick Santelli here. We have April Chicago Purchasing Manager Survey out, down 6 to 56.2, much weaker than the 60 we were expecting. And I have Alice Andres Franz with me from the very organization that put forth this data. Alice, are you a little surprised at the weakness on the headline number?
No, Rick, you know, we were looking for a little bit of weakness. We've had a period where we've seen weak regional reports here in the United States, a weakening in China, and a weakening in the EU. And so this is all very consistent with this data. Putting the data into perspective a little bit here, Rick, we had the production index down to the lowest levels in 29 months. Also, the barometer down to the lowest levels that we've seen since the fall of 2009. Also, we had new orders down big for the second month in a row. Both we were down 5.9 this month and 5.9 last month. Those are two big drops in a row. Inventories are showing that they are not being replenished. And also, we're seeing lead times from suppliers coming at a faster rate. That's signaling a little bit of slowing. Also, you want to take a look at the prices paid. It's coming off a little bit, but you have to remember we had that big spike last month, and I think that the prices coming off is a direct reflection of energy.
What was the prices paid? That was 68.6, and that was down 1.5. So, yes, still very close to 70. Employment index is important to me because Wednesday, of course, we have ADP. Friday, we have the BLS report. I noticed that the employment side was up a little more than 2%. You consider that a positive?
I do, Rick. There was really two positives in this report, employment being one of them. And also, the reason that employment is so important is because it came on the heels of a big decline last month, and you were very worried about that. And then we see a push up
Well, we did have 120,000 jobs report, so
right.
One could say that your organization did pretty well picking up. Let me interrupt you for a second here. Off camera, we were talking about there's a survey attached to this, and I want you to tell me about that briefly. But you said it was optimistic, but I say purchasing managers have been optimistic. GDP report showed a rise in inventories. To me, it's more about do we consume that? But tell us about inventories.
Well, inventories have been coming off for 6 of the last 7 months, and what's that showing is that inventories are just not being replenished. And so it really reflects the caution that these purchasing managers are having moving forward.
But they surveyed fairly optimistic. Can you tell me about
that? They did. And actually, Rick, we have a portion on our survey where we allow the respondents to our survey to give some comments and feedback. And what they're telling me and the purchasing managers that I meet with to help compile this report are telling me that we've seen this before. This is just a little bit of a setback. We are gearing up for a big summer. I have not talked to one purchasing manager that told me that their business is slow, and they are all gearing up for a very strong summer.
We're gearing up for a strong summer. We already have lots of inventory out there. We're going to have to see. The key issue is, will it be consumed? Back to you.
Rick, before we let you go, any comment on a number that was clearly at least available to those who follow Twitter before it hit the tape?
Well, you subscribers get the number a bit early. Alice, very quickly, I believe it's a quarter till that subscribers get the number. Is that correct?
The number comes out at 3 minutes before the public release. So in New York time, it would come out at 9:42 to our subscribers. You can get it online or via a conference call, and then it is released to the general public.
I know
public.
It does seem odd, doesn't it, Carl? Because there are some numbers where subscribers get them early, and I would think early, you know, is a former trader. It bugs me a bit, but it is a free country. I guess people could plop down their couple of hundred bucks.
You can always subscribe, but it did raise a lot of eyebrows this morning because the market reaction did come ahead of the number itself. Rick, thank you for that. Rick Santelli joining us from the CME.